The PanSpace interface makes it easy to pan live tracks and sound effects around a JPEG of the auditorium or performance space in real time or as pre-programmed cues. We'll start with a single cue and six image definitions. For simplicity, we'll just route the input channel to one of six successive outputs at full level. In image 1 to output 1, 2 to 2, and so on, up to image 6 to output 6. Then switch to the PanSpace screen by clicking on the PanSpace icon. On the Images tab, use the Set Graphic button to load the JPEG image. And use the transparency control to adjust contrast. Our six image definitions are listed below. We can drag them onto the JPEG to the locations where we have previously established those image definitions in our actual performance space. Of course, these image definitions will be a bit more complex than a simple fader up as we have done here. Switching to the Inputs tab, we see our input channels 1 to 16. We can drag an input channel anywhere on the JPEG. The pale circle around the node represents the inclusion range. This controls the number of image definitions involved in interpolating the position of the image. A small inclusion range includes only the nearest image definitions. Shift-click where you want the image to move to, and set the time for the move in the box at the bottom of the screen. The default is 1 second. And here our wind sound effect travels from node to node over a period of 1 second. Shift-click to add a few more nodes, and let's change the time from node to node to 2 seconds. And as programmed, our sound effect takes 2 seconds to travel from one node to the next with the inclusion range visualization turned on. Let's turn it off for a bit and place track 2 on the opposite side of the stage. Shift-click to establish a couple of destination nodes for track 2. The time is the default 1 second. Reset the cue and hit go. Track 2 takes the default 1 second to travel from node to node, while track 1 takes the 2 seconds we programmed. To add an intermediate node, click on the preceding node and shift-click where you want the new one. Let's re-enable inclusion range visualization and switch to the mixer screen. As the cue is executed, we see the matrix faders move on matrix channels that are involved in the inclusion range. And here we're looking at the matrix faders for input channel 1. PanSpace is also integrated with the timeline editor. We can edit the nodes on the timeline, in this case spreading them out so that the timing is a bit later. Like other objects on the timeline, nodes can be cut, copied, duplicated, and pasted. Here, we're replacing the nodes on track 2 with a copy of those from track 1, but offset to be just a little later. We see that both tracks now move along the same panning path with the same 2 seconds between nodes. This tight integration between the PanSpace interface and the timeline editor is very useful in timing and aligning events across multiple tracks. When we want to see the pans in all tracks in a queue, we can choose to make visible all channels. Alternatively, we can focus on just one or more selected channels if desired. Moves can also be executed manually. If we look again at the faders in the matrix, we can see how our manual moves translate into changes in the positions of those faders involved in the inclusion range that we've established. Changes in the inclusion range are immediately reflected in the matrix, demonstrating the high level of integration between the PanSpace interface and the mixer. For this dinosaur exhibit, we have 8 output channels to work with. We'll create a forest ambience and have some thunder rolling around the venue. Image definitions 1 to 8 are centered on each output channel in turn, but with sound also feeding adjacent channels about 15 dB down, to create some diffusion in the vicinity. Image definitions 9 and 10 feed two-channel stereo tracks to adjacent odd-even channels around the atrium, to preserve a sense of spaciousness between adjacent pairs of loudspeakers. We'll create our first cue, and then switch to the timeline editor. Drag a forest ambience to tracks 1 and 2. Drag image definition 9 to track 1, so it feeds outputs 1, 3, 5, and 7. And drag image definition 10 to track 2 to feed outputs 2, 4, 6, and 8. We'll loop this ambience continuously and drag our loop in and out points near to the beginning and end of the file. We can fine-tune these later if necessary. We'll choose a dry, rumbling thunder track for our second primordial ambience, and here we'll shift it slowly around the exhibit by dragging image definitions 1, 2, 3, and 4 onto track 1 of the stereo pair at about 15-second intervals. This will make it hard to locate any one particular sound source and will help keep the thunder more realistic. We'll do the same for track 2 with image definitions 5, 6, 7, and 8 on the opposite side of the atrium. This will give our thundering sky some extra spaciousness across the entire width of the venue. Of course, we could slowly rotate it in a complete circle through all 8 output channels. Because we're going to loop this file, we'll morph it back to the initial image definitions, 1 and 5, in order to prevent a sudden jump when it loops. And we'll set the loop count to 2. Following this general approach, we could build up additional ambience tracks to fill out our soundscape, but for now, let's add the thundering footsteps of a Tyrannosaurus Rex to track 5, and we'll have him walk across the far end of the space from one side to the other. For the time being, let's minimize the inclusion range, shift-click where we want him to go, and drag it out a bit further. Set the time to 25 seconds, which is about the duration of the file. Because the footsteps don't begin at time 0 of Q1, we'll drag our nodes onto the beginning and end of the file. Program a few gain points so that the footsteps ramp up from the start to about the middle of the file, and then ramp down again as he walks off into the distance. We'll contour the gain point profile so that it sounds more or less natural, and just tweak it a little bit to get it closer to how we want it. In this two-channel fold-down, the spatial shifts in the rolling thunder are not as perceptible as they would be in real three-dimensional space. But they will add interest and realism to the exhibit. Here he comes. Create Q2, and let's have some spot effects. Some heavy breathing. And for a jump startle effect, that old standby, sudden wing flaps out of underbrush. We'll place those two effects close to our virtual observer. And let's give him a good fright with a giant carnivore. and make that up close and personal. This cue could easily be triggered unwittingly by a visitor tripping a sensor and using a contact closure to MIDI utility and a MIDI cue trigger. But for now, we'll place a go-to command in Q1 and tell it to go to Q2. Let's resize the timeline and have a look at our soundscape as it plays out on the timeline and in PanSpace. When Q2 starts to play from the go-to command, note how the input channels that are displayed in PanSpace change to reflect the programming that we've done in Q2, even as Q1 continues to play as programmed in the background. Loops are executed in our ambience tracks, and we're off to a productive start.